Now we're still going to have some days off, so for that we have this off 24 hours. So let's go with the first week of January. Let's say it's closed, and then the last couple of days. In this video, I'm going to be showing you how to adjust the building operating schedule in new Revit 2025. So if you don't know, in the latest version of Revit, Revit 2025, we now have the ability to adjust the building operating schedule day by day, so we can adjust the whole year if we have some periods when the building isn't being used. So if it's seasonal use or something like that, we can now fully adjust that. And I'm going to be showing you how to use this menu and how to adjust everything. Previously, we had this kind of simple menu where we could only adjust the occupancy throughout the day, but now we can actually adjust it throughout the entire year, day by day, which is really cool. And then, just for fun, we're going to be creating some analytical spaces and generating an analysis report. Let's go. Now, quickly, before we jump into Revit, I would just like to ask you to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com. I'm going to link it up in the cards above and then also down in the description of this video. If you're serious about learning Revit, that's definitely the best place to be. Now, without any further ado, let's jump straight into Revit. And here we are in Revit, and this is the rendering of the building that we're going to be using for this demonstration. It's a museum design, and if you're interested in this project, please let me know in the comment section, and perhaps I can make a full video on this project that we have created in Revit. And here we have the floor plan, and to start our analysis, we first need to place a space. Now, what you'll notice is that we already have a space placed here, so it looks kind of like a room. However, this is not a room, it's a space. So instead of placing it as your room, you can just go here to analyze, and here we have spaces and zones, and then you can just place this as a space. So that's basically how you place a space. You adjust the limit offset, so at the height of the space, and that's pretty much it. So once we have the space in place, then we can continue, and we can see here in the instance properties for this space, we have all of the information. Now I'm just going to scroll all the way down until I find energy analysis, and here we have the space type. So currently this is set to building, which is going to be kind of the default option, and when we click on this little builder button, it's going to open up the space type settings. And here, as you can see, we have different settings options that we can choose from. So these are kind of all of the presets. So I'm actually going to search for general exhibition museum, and I'm going to start off with this one because, well, this is a museum project, so it makes sense to go with this one. Then once we have picked this, then here in the parameters, we can see all of the values. Now, one that I'm interested in is the occupation schedule. And here, as you can see, it's set to retail facility occupation. Now I can click here and then click on this little button, which is going to open up the schedule settings menu. And this is the menu that we're going to be talking about in this video. So by default, in this case, it was set to this. Here, as you can see, we have many different year schedules that we can choose from. And I'm actually going to start with this one. And then here we have the buttons to create a new one, or in this case, it makes more sense to duplicate this one. And then once this is duplicated, we can rename it here. As you can see, it just added this one. So I can select this, delete, and then let's name it Museum Yearly Schedule. So here we can set up the yearly schedules. Here we have the whole calendar year with all of the days. And then here we have the presets for each day that we can use here. So in this case, let's see, and let's try to find a preset that's closest to our operating schedule. Let's see, the on 9 a.m. to 9 p.m. And let's say I want to use this one, so I can just select it. And again, we have the same tools to create a new day or to duplicate the existing one. I'm just going to duplicate this one. And then let's rename this to Museum Daily Schedule. Now here you can see all of the hours in a day, and then we can set up the percentage of how occupied our space is throughout that day. So here I'm going to start off with 50% at 9 a.m. and then I'm just going to continue at 50 and then increasing to 60 at noon, and then we can go to 80 here from 3 p.m. And then let's say that it's at maximum occupancy starting from 6 p.m. until the museum closes. So now we have kind of defined this day preset. So that's going to be our museum daily schedule. And then we can just search for it here. Here we go. There's our museum daily schedule. And now it's time to apply this. So I can just click here and make sure that this is the active daily schedule. And then I can go to my calendar and then I can say, okay, so this is going to be for work days. So let's go from Monday and then go to Friday and fill out this whole kind of area. And then I'm going to continue doing that here this day as well. And there we go. So now we have assigned our museum daily schedule. Then I can pick out a new one that I want to use for the weekends. So I'm just going to select any one of these. So let's go with this one, for example. I'm just going to duplicate that one. And then let's call this one the museum weekend schedule. And then I'm actually going to change this so it's not going to be working at 8 a.m. or 9 a.m. Let's say it opens at noon. So let's go like this. And then at 12 p.m., let's say it starts off at 60%, 60, and then gradually goes up during the day, 80. And then here at 6 p.m., it's at 90. And then let's say we're at 100% for the last 3 hours, which is going to be like this. So in this case, it's going to be working from 12 p.m. until 10 p.m. So we have adjusted this museum weekend schedule. And then let's find it here. So here we go, museum weekend schedule. And then I can just select all of the weekend days. Okay, so we have filled out most of the year. Now we're still going to have some days off. So for that, we have this off 24 hours. So that's going to work perfectly fine. We don't have to adjust it. So let's go with the first week of January. Let's say it's closed and then the last couple of days in the year. Oops, so here I messed up. So what I can do here is just go back and then find museum weekend schedule and go like this and daily schedule and go like that just to fix it up. And there we go. So now I have set up this yearly schedule for our museum. So I can say apply, okay, and exit that menu. So now this is assigned for our museum exhibition space. And now we can run some analysis and see what we get. So for the analysis, I'm just going to deselect this space, then go to the Analyze tab. Here we have the Energy Optimization panel. And first I like to double check the location. So let's say this museum for energy analysis purposes is located in Belgrade, Serbia. So that's fine, click OK. Then we can go to Energy Settings and just check the settings. I'm also going to check the other options just to make sure that here, yeah, the export category, I want to change it from rooms to spaces. Click OK, OK again. And then finally, let's click on Create Energy Model. Yep, let's create it, OK. And here we go. So here we have our energy model, and then we can select these individual spaces that were created. And here we can see the occupancy load. So this is the current occupancy load. And depending on that yearly schedule, as you change it, this occupancy load is obviously going to change because the museum isn't open 24 hours all year long. So it's really important to have the ability to set this up correctly and precisely. And now let's also create a system analysis report. So I'm just going to set this to annual building energy simulation and run analysis. And once the report is done, this is what we have. So as you can see, this is what our report looks like. So we can just explore it. We can see a monthly overview. This is what that looks like, and so on and so forth. So this is all affected by that annual occupancy schedule that we have created and adjust it for the particular schedule or working schedule of our museum. So that's going to conclude this video. I hope you have learned something new. Please tell me in the comment section below, is this something that you have used before, and do you plan to use this feature in the future? Also, if you would like to get access to this Revit project file, you can find that on my Patreon page, which I'm going to link up in the cards above and then also down in the description of this video. There you can find all of my Revit project files from these YouTube tutorials. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.